3D printing, robotics, and AI, which is sort of intertwined in both robotics and 3D printing. This is really going to change the entire manufacturing landscape. It's going to allow for more efficient production, parts that are better designed for what they're supposed to do, parts that have designs that humans could have never imagined because AI created those designs. This is clearly a growth industry, and we think that opportunity will soon be realized, but it's not realized yet. So as investors, you know, it gives us an edge, it gives us an opportunity. Around the 2014 timeline, when 3D printing stocks really took a turn, this was mainly because of overhype in the consumer side of the market, this idea that there'd be a 3D printer in everyone's house. That never materialized. We don't think that it will. We think 3D printing is really beneficial for the industrial space, you know, aerospace, healthcare, maybe automotive. The other thing that was happening around that time period was the strong US dollar. That caused a lot of the end consumers of 3D printing to cut back on spending. We also saw the Chinese industrial recession that weighted on these stocks. Since that time period, we're seeing the major 3D printing companies like Stratasys, like 3D Systems, really focusing on a customer model, meaning that they're partnering with the end users of 3D printing, like Airbus, and understanding their requirements to fine-tune the technology and the printers to fit those requirements. So they're shifting away from what might have been focused on the consumer, sort of more the gimmicky area of 3D printing, to this industrial opportunity, which of course we think is much larger. Right now, there are only thousands of parts being 3D printed for aircraft, but there are millions of parts on an airplane. So we think many more of those could be 3D printed in the future. No, that's just one industry. We think 3D printing can really touch all industries that use manufacturing. We see a lot more opportunity in the industrial space. But because, you know, that dream was sort of shattered, and actually even some of the public 3D printing manufacturers bought into this idea, it really scared investors away from the space. So right now what we see is a lot of these stocks are really being heavily discounted in the market. We see 3D printing stocks trading like value stocks in what really is a growth industry. We think that, you know, that business model transition was a really important piece of change that the industry needed to go through. So we're really excited.